Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about if, elif and else statements in Python. So for example, if I write down 1 less than 2, put a colon here, and if I write down a statement like print, suppose yes. So this is how if you can write down if condition. If, then the condition, and then whatever the result you want to print. But remember, there is a block of white space before print, which is very important in Python. In Python, brackets are not used in order to separate block execution statements. It uses white space instead. So this is a white space. So if I run it with shift enter, you can see the result now. Yes. Another example is if I change the condition, if 2 less than 1, and if I try to print this one, print, suppose I'd have a result here, and now in this case this was true, in this case this is not true, so it is not going to show any result because this condition is not true. So if it's true, then only it is going to execute this particular statement, which is in the if block. If condition is satisfied, then only it is going to execute this print statement in this example. If there is a condition like if 2 equal to 2, and if I write down some statement here like print, you can use single quotes or double quotes. For example, here I am trying to use double quotes, so there is no problem, and try to run it, shift enter. So this condition is true, that's why it is going to show the result. Instead of that, if I write down it like this, if true, we already seen boolean operations. If I write down it like this, if true, and try to print some statement, suppose it is going to execute the code. If I write down a statement like this, execute the code, so it is going to print it, because this condition should be true, then only this statement is going to execute. So for example, if I write down if true, some expression, if I write down, it is also going to execute that x is equal to, for example, 2 plus 5, so it is going to execute this one. If I type x here now and shift enter, see, you can see the result of x, it is 7. 2 plus 5 is 7. Now if there is more than one condition, what we can do is you can use if else. For example, if 1 less than 2, put a colon here and write down some statement, for example, print. I want to print first here. If condition is true, then it is going to print first. If and else condition is not true, what I want is I want put a colon here and I want this one to be printed. If condition is not true, I want last this word to be printed. So if condition is true, it is going to print this one, otherwise it is going to print this one. It is if else. So in this case, 1 less than 2, it is true, that's why it has printed first. So if I change it 1 greater than 2, so it is going to be a false condition, and then it is going to print last. Let's try. I made the changes and I will run it. Now it is going to print last. You can check it here. Another example is we can use not equal to. For example, if 1 not equal to 2, so which is true actually, execute this statement, print, for example, print some name here, sorry, and if that is not true, that is in else, put a colon here, do not forget to put colon, print some other name here. So in this case, 1 not equal to 2 is true, that's why it is going to show you this name, Yogesh. So let's check, run it, so you can check it. So this is a sign for not equal to. But the point to remember is, in case of block statement, Python uses space, or it is called as indentation. It is not going to use parentheses. So there are a lot of examples. If you consider this example, if 1 equal to equal to 2, which is not true. I want to print some name, for example, again same name we are going to use, Yogesh. And in else we will use the same thing which we are using earlier example. So in this case 1 equal to equal to 2 is not true, so in this case we are going to get Brahmkar. So this is what our result will be. You can check again because this is not true. Now what if we have more than one conditions or multiple conditions? So in that case we will go with elif statements. So let's see how. If 1 equal to equal to 2, for example, I want to print first, I want to again give one condition. So elif, this is how you are going to use elif. Elif 3 equal to equal to 3, put a colon here and print some result. Suppose I want to print this one, middle. I want one more condition, or not a condition, if that condition is not true. If this condition is not true, it is going to go to elif, that is else if. And if this is not true, it is going to print whatever in else. So in else, for example, I want print, so first, middle, and I want to print last. So in this case, what is going to happen is, this condition is not true, this condition is true, so it is going to print middle. Let's check. So see, it has printed middle. So this is how you can use elif. It is very, very important in programming for Python. One last example is, for example, if 1 equal to equal to 2, put a colon here and print some result. Again, we will use the same example. First, now if I have more than one condition, what will happen in that case? So elif, for example, 5 equal to 5, I want to print this one, second. Okay, and one more condition is there, for example, it is like this, 6 equal to 6. So again I can use elif 6 equal to equal to 6, put a colon here, and I want to print the result, for example, third. And if both the conditions are not true, we will go with else and print the result like this, for example, fourth. So in this case you can check if 1 equal to equal to 2, this if condition is not true, then go to else if, and then if this is not true, then go to this else if, and if three of them they are not true, it is going to go to else, so it is going to print fourth if all of them they are not true. But in this case, even though there are more than one condition true here, but only first instance of the condition being true is executed, that is this one, so it is going to print second. So let's check. So you can check the result. So this is how you can use if, elif and else statements. There are more examples possible, but they are very, very important. These concepts are very, very important for Python programming. So that's it, friends. In the next video we are going to talk about for loops. Thank you very much.